All I learned, oh, that this seemed mysterious to me. At that time, I was much taken with the photographs of Lardugue, and I wanted to make
Here's
photographs
a
as mysterious as
picture
his,
of
without,
downtown
however,
Prescott on Whiskey
detecting
Row,
cover and width.
of some
All I
famous
learned
hotel.
was that the
I
two
can't
were
remember
somehow
which one
bound
it was. I
together.
just took it to
Anyway,
appease my
my eye for
passerbys.
mystery is defective, so this
Apparently,
may be the only example I'll
no
ever
one in
produce.
Prescott takes
Nevertheless,
pictures, because
because very
as
difficult
I
negative print, I find that I can do
put
so
my
less and less
tripod
often.
out and
This
set my
photograph of
camera
two
up,
toys was made in 19.
made it for
It was
the
made in
correct
February of
exposure.
1964. With a new
I had
camera
everyone
I just got in
and
the
their mother stopping
As
me
you
to
can
ask
see,
me if I was
the
shooting for the
head image
Historical
was made
Society.
in Renaissance Crucification. The outline of the cross is quite clear.
I wasn't,
Ivan's
of course,
clothes
but
mold on the right represents the Blessed Virgin. On the left
kind
is
of
St. Mary Magdalene.
helped them
The
out
bowl
by
is the
saying, yeah,
fourth
I'm
wave.
shooting some pictures of Prescott,
The roll of
so
toilet paper stands to
where should I
swollen
take a
atom.
picture? And they
The
pointed
center
upwards,
stage,
so that
conventionally
sign's
marked
pretty
away
old.
by the
Why don't you take that
blood-stained
sign?
crucified
So I did.
Savior sheds. The stairs leading up to the two booths symbolize Calvary.
Here's another
I'm not
photo
really
project.
Certain of the
For ASU, it was an identity project. I kind of set myself up in a police lineup of sorts. I did
a painter friend asked me to make a photograph,
roughly 100 photos,
a photographic document of spaghetti,
facing the camera
an
and turning to the left.
To the work of his own.
And
I set up my camera above an empty darkroom.
This
tray,
is this is one of them. I borrowed my ex-wife now. I borrowed
I
her fur coat
until I saw
and
a random arrangement of pasta and finished
put that on, and it kind
of
looked cold, and it was
the
middle of summer,
I left
so
it, there
it was kind of interesting.
I made one photograph every day. This was the 18th such photograph. The spaghetti has dried without rotting. The sauce is a kind of pink varnish on the yellow strains. The entirety is covered in attractive, mature colonies of mold in three colors, black, green, and white. I continued the series until no further change appeared to be taking place. About 2 months altogether. The spaghetti was never entirely consumed, but the mold eventually disappeared. This photograph was made in Michael Snow's studio sometime in 1965. It was made into a poster announcing a show of his Walking Woman works at the Poindexter Gallery in that year. As many as possible of the pieces are seen by reflection or transmission in
this
a transparent sheet of acrylic plastic,
is,
which
one
is
my
itself
lighting
part
with,
of a piece.
My boom
the result
light.
Is probably confusing, but no more so than the show apparently was, since it seems to have been studiously ignored.
My first divorce.
If you look closely, you can see Michael Snow himself
would lead to
on the
my
left
second divorce,
by transmission,
but,
and my camera on the right.
This is my second wife at the time.
Pretending
to sleep, and my hands on her left arm,
for two or three exposures.
Essentially saying goodbye as I leave.
The postler
and
he said I had
on her left hand is her wedding ring, the band
I regret
that
to say
she was
right.
able to
but it was
hang
too late.
On to,
there was nothing
the
to do
two
about it.
Rings
the whole
that,
business still troubles
we had gotten
me. I wish I could apologize to
subsequently lost. Very interesting how
reclining on his bed,
perhaps it wasn't as important to her, who knows. It's just very interesting the way these photographs come back to me and speak different things to me.
And left. Later on, I was sent a check for the photograph that I had thought inadequate by half. I returned to the magazine with a letter of explanation. They sent me another check for the amount I asked for, $75. Months later, the photograph was published. I was working in a color film laboratory at the time. My boss saw the photograph, and I nearly lost my job. I decided to stop doing this sort of thing. I did not make this photograph, nor do I know who did, nor can I recall precisely when it was made. It was printed in a newspaper, so I suppose that any patient person with an interest in this sort of thing could satisfy himself entirely as to its origins. The image is slightly indistinct. A stubby, middle-aged man wearing a baseball cap looks back in a matter-of-fact dismay or disgruntlement at the camera. It has caught him in the midst of a
identity
spheres,
project,
each about the size of a grapefruit,
photograph,
and some nondescript color. He holds four of them in his left hand.
I downed one of my sweaters and my scarf covering my face. I'm not sure why, but I thought that it would look interesting. This one actually
seems to be with the spheres. They seem absolutely
sent out to a few friends via postcard.
What does it mean? I'm uncertain,
with a stamp
but
at all.
Willing to offer a
very
plausible explanation.
One of
the man
things
the
I didn't follow up on.
His orchids
and,
lie near the Gulf of Mexico. The spheres are grapefruit.
Digital photos.
As they
every week.
Neared maturity, a hurricane flooded
Cost
the orchard and knocked down the fruit.
Key.
The man is stunned by his commercial loss.
Here's
and a little resentful
downtown Prescott
of the photographer
photo.
Who who intrudes the trees, upon his attempts
the shadow of the trees.
On the other hand,
everything just looks so great beside the
then this image might date from the
breezy,
time of,
cold
let us
wind.
Say, Pascal, and I suppose
that didn't sit too well with us. And I enjoyed taking pictures down in Prescott like to do it when it wasn't so cold.
I made a few photographs. This has been partly through design and partly through laziness. I think
every
I
other brick inside of this particular walkway said something about Prescott and its history. So it's been interesting to walk along and read
so
that.
So it is all the more surprising that I felt again a few weeks ago a vagrant.
This particular picture is me and my daughter. I'm walking out of the house and she's still stuck in it. Both of us no longer live in this house. She doesn't have a room in it anymore.
So I obeyed it. I wandered around for hours, unsatisfied.
Interesting, this was supposed to emulate my first divorce and how it came to show my second divorce and where I'm at now in my life.
A dark tunnel
interests me, and I think about it from time to time.
A truck turned into the alley, the driver stopped, got out, and walked away. He left his
this particular photograph actually spawned another assignment. So here's my last photograph.
I did so, and then went home to develop my single negative.
Very interesting.
When I came to print the negative,
handheld about 1 a.m., parting of friends.
Was reflected in the fact
one of our friends was leaving for Paris. Or France, perhaps, and we had a gathering, and I took lots of pictures.
Since then, I've enlarged a small section of my negative enormously. The grain of the film all but obliterates the feature of the image.
Could have been 2 a.m.
It is obscure.
The light from the street lamps across was able to produce this weird effect in the sky, almost like it was dawn, but wasn't near dawn.
I shall never dare to take another photograph again.
Photo.
Here it is. Look at it.
Fond memories
of that
night.
Do you see what I see?
Definitely helped me stake my claim to my direction of photography. And now video.
We're good. We're done. Thini. Oh. Thank you.
Very interesting material subject matter.
Good.